Namaste to aspirants of Ayurveda. I am Dr. Mangala Gauri Rao, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University. And I am very happy to share with certain secrets of Ayurveda on the concept of health, wellness and disease. Various aspects have been told in the Ayurveda in the holistic way, starting from the definition of health, including the physical, mental and spiritual domains. The components mentioned in WHO definition of health were already described in Sushruta Samhita in definition of Swastha. Further, there is a striking resemblance mentioned in dimensions of health elaborately mentioned in the modern text and features of health described by Acharya Kashyapa. Various domains have been described, including physical domain, mental domain, spiritual domain. In the physical domain, the aspects like the equilibrium status of doshas, like in Ayurveda, our body is made up of three doshas, Vata, Pitta and Kapha. These should be in the state of normalcy. Along with that, the Agni. Agni is a factor that is responsible for the digestion of the ingested food as well as assimilation of the food. Further, the metabolism or conversion of the food into the tissues, that is dhatus. These factors together is known by the name Agni, and the balanced state of tissues or the dhatus. In Ayurveda, seven dhatus have been described, that is rasa, rakta, mausa, medha, asthi, shukra and majja. These seven dhatus should be in the status of equilibrium. Along with that, the digestion of food or the conversion of the dhatus leads to the formation of certain malas or the toxins in the body which need to be excreted from time to time from the body. So these malas should be excreted properly. Then at the same time, these are the physical components and even the mental component, which involves the prasannatmendriya mana or the status of pleasantness of the atma. Here the soul does not mean the paramatma or the ultimate soul, but it is the jivatma, that which is having the sensations of pleasure and pain, etc. Along with that, the status of excellence of the indriyas, or the which includes the sense organs as well as the motor organs, including the mana or the mind. All these together form the state of health, which is given by the quotation sama dosha sama agnischa sama dhatu malakriya prasannatmendriya manaha swastha ityabhidiyate by Acharya Sushruta in the chapter number 15 of Sutrasthana. Further, elaborating upon the physical components of the health, Acharya Kashyapa has given further details about the positive features of the health, which includes the proper desire for the food as well as easy digestion of the ingested food. Because until and unless the food is taken properly, the nourishment of the dhatus or the maintenance of the agni is not possible. Further, proper formation and expulsion of the excreta. Along with that, the feeling of lightness in the body and normally sensor and motor functions of the body, together with the mental health that is maintained by the physical component, like the comfortable sleep and waking up cycle that is very much important in the wellness of an individual, as well as the strength and complexion which provide the long life or longevity to the individual, and also the pleasant state of mind, which is a deciding factor for the physical health as well as the mental health, and the Agni, which is the key factor for the formation of the dhatus as well as digestion of the food. All these factors have again been considered by the definition of Acharya Kashyapa, wherein he tells Annabhilasho bhuktasya paripakah sukhena cha srishta vinmutra matatvam sharirasya cha lagavam suprasannendriyatvam cha sukha svapna prabodhanam balavarnayusho labha saumanasyam samagnita vidyat arogya lingani. That is the features of positive health as explained by Acharya Kashyapa. Further, Acharya Charaka again gives the emphasis upon the physical features and how exactly the formative organs should be there. That has been mentioned. Here he tells about Sama Mamsa Pramanastu, that is the proportionate body and strong sensory and motor organs, that is Sama Mamsa Pramanastu Sama Samhanano Naraha, that is the compactness is proper, along with that the Indriyo Dridendriya Vikaranam Na Balena Abhibhuyate, that is the sense organs should be very strong, and the Vikaranam Na Balena Abhibhuyate, that is the diseases are not having much strength because the body strength is more. Kshut Pipasa Sah Atapasah, that is one can withstand the hunger or thirst, as well as adversities of the climates like the excessive heat or cold. Shita Vyayama Samsahah, that is excessive exercise, excessive cold, and Sama Pakta Samajaraha, whatever the food that is being taken is digested properly as well as metabolized properly. Sama Mamsa Chayomataha, that is the mamsa is formed properly, but even though the word mamsa has been used, it implies all the other dhatus also, because the bala or the ojas is depending on the status of all the dhatus. Further, strong perceptive power and good complexion, state of excellence of the tissues, all these form the very good component for the healthy glowing skin, which is one of the components for the features of the health. Further, how these maintenance health can be done? I was speaking about the balance between the doshas, dhatus and balas, and these things can be possible only with the help of the sub pillars or the secondary vital supports, which help in the nourishment of the body and maintenance of the body, that are ahara or the food, nidra or the sleep, and brahmacharya or the celibacy. This will enhance the body strength, complexion as well as the nourishment. If we think about the diet or ahara, it always nourishes the body, provides the strength instantaneously, and gives sturdiness to the body. It also enhances the longevity because it enhances the strength as well as luster and complexion, clarity of the skin, and the enthusiasm or the energy, because the energy is given by the food. So all these components together, that is food in the form of different dhanyas, or it is also mentioned in the modern as the cereals and pulses, they are included under the shuka dhanya and shami dhanya, and the various vegetables and fruits that are included under the shaka varga and phala varga, as well as the pulses which are included among the Shimbidanya. So all these together will be helping in the nourishment along with the factors that will rejuvenate the body like the milk and the ghee. Further, always rest is one of the most essential factor for the health as well as prevention of the disease. This provides nourishment, strength, virility, longevity, and also it prevents the factors. And improper sleep results in variety of disorders starting from the headache to the heaviness of body, dizziness, itching, urticaria, and pimples. Similarly, the Brahmacharya has been mentioned by our acharyas, but in the present context, this may be not suitable 100%. So, the Abrahmacharya that has been mentioned by Acharya Vagbhata is more practicable because Brahmacharya means abstinence from the sexual activity, but Abrahmacharya is having the sexual intercourse with the rules and regulations as per Ayurveda. This will help in bringing about the longevity, lustre, strength, energy, knowledge, success, and attractiveness. So all these three pillars together help in enhancing the bala as well as nourishment and complexion, which are one among the components of the physical health. Further, the different ahara what we take always help in enhancing the digestion power. Ahara, if taken in proper quantity at a proper time with consideration about our body in the form of the conducive and non-conducive food or avoidance of the viruddhahara or incompatible food, all these factors will help in enhancing the bala of an individual. Similarly, a proper sleep, that is timely sleep, one has to get up in the Brahmi Muhurta and sleep at a proper time. This will help in enhancing the energy of a person as well as prevention of the diseases. Further, the Abrahmacharya, as told earlier, helps in the conservation of Shukra, because Acharya Sharangdhara considers Ojas as a Upadhatu of Shukra. So this particular Shukra, if we are conserving, then it will help in enhancing the strength of an individual. So thus it is helpful in promoting the health. Further, these three things, that is Ahara, along with that Vihara and Vichara, will act as a key for good health. And it has been mentioned in our classics, Nityam Hitahara Viharak Sevi Samikshyakari Visheshvasaktaha Data Samaha Satya Paraha Kshamavan Aptopasevi Bhavatya Rogaha. That is Nityam Hitahara Vihara Sevi. One has to take the conducive food as well as follow the conducive lifestyle. Samikshyakari, one has to analyze himself, what activities he is doing, what food he is taking, what good he is doing, what bad he has to avoid. All this analysis has to be done. And Vishayeshu Asaktaha, that is, he should be disinterested towards the worldly things. He should not have excessive attachment or excessive detachment or have to have interest in the work he is doing. And Data, he has to be generous, and Samaha, always balanced, whether he faces a failure or whether he faces a success, he should be in a balanced state. Satya Paraha, always he should be towards the truth. And Kshamavan, one has to forgive the mistakes of other and himself. And Aptopasevi, that is the, these are the principles that have been told by our acharyas, who are considered as apta, or one whose suggestions, if we are following, then always good is going to happen. Such apta, vachana or the things told by the person, if we follow, then bhavati arogaha, that is, he will be devoid of any diseases. So one has to take a proper food to protect his digestion, and one has to take the food according to his body condition as well as strength and the mode of work he is doing, and according to the seasons as well as age one belongs to. All these factors has to be considered. Further, how exactly the food should be? That is, hita ahara, hitashi. One has to take a conducive food. What does this hitahara mean? That includes a balanced diet that can be considered as the shashtika shali or the rice, or mudga or the factors that involve the protein that includes all the pulses, and amalaki or the Indian gooseberry, that is a source of vitamin as well as good source of antioxidant, and as per Ayurveda it is a very good rasayana or the rejuvenator, and along with that some amount of the sugars in the form of honey and also the water in a proper content. Along with that, as previously mentioned, the intake of ghee and milk, all these together that come under the hitahara. And mitashi, that is in the moderate quantity. One has to take the food in a moderate quantity. One should never overfill the stomach. Only one has to stop eating before he feels satiety. That is, 2/3 of the stomach should be filled and 1/3 should be left empty for the proper digestion to take place. And kala bhoji, that is, at a proper time one has to take the food. Again, when to take the food depends upon how exactly we are working, or else our mental status also it depends on. So, and jitendriya, that is, all these things are possible only when one has the control over his senses and his mind. Then if he follows all these things, then pashyan rogan bahun kashtan buddhiman vishamashanat, that is, all the difficult diseases can be prevented if one indulges in these conducive habits and avoids the vishamashana or irregular intake of food or improper intake of food. All these things that is included under the heading of dinacharya, rutucharya and ratricharya. It has been mentioned by Acharya Bhava Prakasha, dinacharya nishacharya rutucharya yathodita acharan purushah swastah sada tishtati nanyata. These are the different lifestyles that have been described by our acharyas for prevention of the disorders. Along with that, one has to avoid the forceful creation of the natural urges as well as suppression of the natural urges. This also comes under the healthy lifestyle. Acharya Vagbhata tells, rogaha sarvepi jayante vego dhirana dharanaihi. Further, vichara. If we think about the mindset, always various ethical things have been mentioned in Ayurveda under the context of sadvritta, wherein what things we have to do, that is, respecting the elders or respecting the persons whom we are associated with, as well as doing the respecting our environment, and so many other factors are included under the sadvritta. Further, dharaniya vegas include the control of the mental urges. That is, six factors have been considered as an enemy for an individual. That is, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsara. That is, excessive desire, excessive anger, excessive greed, and the excessive ego and excessive jealousy. All these things have to be avoided. Further, achara rasayana, wherein the lifestyle itself acts as the rejuvenator, that have been mentioned along with the regular practice of the pranayama and meditation for the mental health or the improving our mental health promotion. Further, the disease has also been described in Ayurveda. It has been mentioned, erroneous lifestyle and erroneous food habits have been one of the most important causative factor along with the intellectual errors, that is classified under prajnaparadha, and the time factor, like how long we are doing it or what is the amount of the prajnaparadha or the mithya vihara that one is following. These all factors, that is trivida hetu sangraha, it has been mentioned, three important causative factor for the diseases, and derangement of the digestion and assimilation along with the metabolism or vitiation of the three doshas and the dhatus will be leading to the diseases. And these derangement of the dhatus along with the sroto vaigunya or the channels will be deranged, that will be leading to the disease. So to conclude this lecture, the definition of the swastha has been mentioned in the Sushruta Samhita, wherein it mentions about the equilibrium state of the humors, agni, body tissues, and proper expulsion of the excretory products, as well as blissful state of soul, senses and mind. Features of positive health as per Acharya Kashyapa, and three important body sub-supports or the Trayopastamba, as well as key for the health, that is diet, lifestyle and mental makeup. These two together form the components for the wellness as per Ayurveda. Thank you for listening to the lecture. Thank you very much.